So I had a request for a tour of my crafty space. My first thought was, that won't take long. My space is small and pretty frugal, and I've had to make it very space efficient because it's very small. It's not like most of the dream spaces we've seen online, but I'm so grateful to have a space that is all my own to do what I love to do. I hope you enjoy the tour, and maybe you'll see something that gives you an idea for your space. This is a CD spinner rack that holds 144 CDs. These are some of my smaller unmounted stamps, and they're organized by category. Here I have some bits of ribbon and twine in candy containers. An old wipes tub with extra dyes, and a plastic tub with extra bottles of glue and finishes. Here are some pictures of crafty friends, and on the other side of the spinner I attached two adhesive hooks to hold my brayers. On the shelves below the spinner, I have some drywall tape and fancy ribbon storage. Those are rolls of ribbon in shoe boxes. Here are some pads of watercolor paper, other foam pads and cutting pads, and then some longer paper that doesn't fit anywhere else. On the top of my desk, I have some solvents, and then in the crispy cracker tins is pattern paper that I've cut down to 6x6. Here's some more repurposed storage. Those are ice cream containers on the left. And this is a storage unit I asked for at the grocery store that was from Energy Bar. So I have all my tapes in there. Watercolor scraps that I can't throw away. A work in progress. Rulers and some other pieces of plastic. And in the ice cream containers are some stamps that I need to put away and some projects that are still in progress. On this level are some snapware containers that I'm using as drawers. They're each sort of organized by category. These are paint pots, some mica products, and glazes. Some other small mounted stamps and stamps for cardbacks. Here's my Mamadini logo. In this drawer I have some confetti and some mica flakes and mica powders. And this is ephemera and some other alterable things. In this drawer unit, I have some watercolor markers, some chalk pads, and then my collection of gelatos. This is my fancy stencil storage. It's made out of two powdered milk boxes. I need to show you what I keep bumping into here. This is my video camera mount. I don't know if you can tell what it is. I'll give you a closer look. This is a badminton racket, screwed to the top of an old drawer with one of those grabby camera mounts desperately hanging on to the end. And this is where my camera goes when I make videos. This is my marker storage unit, and we divided the desk space using some thin plywood. Underneath is another drawer, and that is full of sharpeners and staplers and stamps I don't want to put away and some other tools. The rest of that level is full of ink pads and sponges. These are some paper scraps that I couldn't bear to put away because they created some wonderful color combinations while I was cleaning my desk. This is my pencil storage, and you may know that I'm a bit of a pencil addict. I have six of these cases. They are global classic leather cases. So I'll show you the inside of one of those. These are my watercolor pencils. And they are in my favorite rainbow order, in their cozy elastic straps. These cases are so great for travel and just for compact storage. I really, really love them. Maybe you can tell that I really, really love them. Here's some more marker storage, some flatback gems, and a paint palette. And the tins below, those are also cracker tins. There's some half and quarter sheets of cardstock, and these are my acrylic blocks, which are super, super dirty. Water for another project. Pen and pencil storage. This is one of my favorite reminders on my desk. This is my Mary Englebright snap out of its stamp. And my famed Mama mug. This is Mama on the handle. And I love it. Underneath this custom ink pad rack, I have some more fancy storage. These are chocolate chip containers, and they fit just perfectly in there with all kinds of trim and buttons and other things. Here's a look at the top of the ink pad rack. There's a favorite canvas and some other wood-mounted stamps that I just love to look at. House Mouse and some Winnie the Pooh, Inky Antics. There's my cutie sewing machine. This is my die storage, and these are divider sheets that are covered with magnetic vent covers to hold my smaller dies. I have some tools back behind there. And then this is my larger card stock, again in rainbow order. The unit that it's sitting on is a shoe storage unit that is completely falling apart, hence the duct tape. But I keep my scraps in that unit in heavy-duty page protectors. In the bottom of that unit, I have some binders, and those binders also hold unmounted stamps. The other binders are clear stamps, and I have those in page protectors that I've sewed to create pockets. The larger sets, I've just sewed one line across, and the others I've sewed a line down and across to create pockets for those stamps. Here's a look underneath my desk. There's my larger Spore Pal. In the wood box is ribbon storage. And that is an old cassette case that I removed the dividers from. And the ribbon is, of course, in rainbow order on pieces of cereal boxes. Underneath that, I keep some extra cards. That tote in the back is bottles of reinker. Underneath is extra card stock. Here are my acrylic paints. I have some clear sets and then a drawer unit. The top drawer is glitters and embossing powders. This is a drawer of charms and jewelry supplies. And the bottom drawer has more unmounted stamps. I'm very blessed to have stamping friends around the world, so these are cards from some of them. My husband built me a second desk unit, and it has lots of shelves up top for storage. This is mostly older unmounted stamps, extra ink pads, extra jewelry supplies, and embellishments. Those are in fishing tackle boxes. I have some product organized by company, mounted stamps. This is my health class teaching material. It takes up some space here, too. I have some books. Some of these are devotional books. Flower Soft. More stamps. These down below are quote books and other books that I use for stamp designing. My Big Shot has a place on this desk, and it pulls out when I need to use it. Here's some more fancy storage for my embossing folders. Lots of desky junk. There's my blog calendar. Some other fun reminders, and a canvas that I painted. This is a magnet board that I made from the top of a pencil tin. And here is my laptop where we hang out at Split Coast Stampers. And there's me. These are color charts for my pencils and markers that help me keep organized and also help me choose colors when I'm coloring. I also wanted to show some still photos of my storage units just to give you a closer look in case you need some ideas for organizing your space. Just to keep it in perspective, too, my space is rarely ever this clean. This is what my desk normally looks like, and that's because I use it. Whatever your space looks like, I hope you're using it, too, and you're grateful for what you have. Thank you so much for watching.